fellas. Hey, everybody in here real quick. Fellas. Go.
And how you score points is if the ball hits the rim at all, if it hits twice, or it hits the ground. That's how you score points. So you have 3 hits to get it back to the other guy. Right?
Opa!
There we go. Right? Does that make sense? You have 3 hits. It cannot hit the rim at all at any point. It can't hit the rim and then go
over there.
The
2 on this right. 3 over there.
4 guys per station.
Yes!
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You sir!
Yes, sir!
With the 2nd pick in the 1994 NBA draft, the Dallas Mavericks select Jason Kidd from the University of California.
Rookie of the year.
Shoot up a 3. He got it!
An NBA championship.
And a celebration will begin. The Dallas Mavericks are NBA champions. The first title in franchise history.
In the Hall of Fame. Jason Kidd set an incredibly high standard during his playing career. But now he's the man setting the expectations for 20 players, attempting to live up to that legacy.
You're preparing for 20 players, a new coaching staff, and so there's a lot of meetings, there's a lot of communication. The one thing, you want training camp to be exciting, you want it to be fresh, fun, and so we kind of set this tempo, fast pace, not standing around, and so I think the players' feedback so far has been great.
Understand, the guys on the ball, I'm asking you, right, your partners right here, is you got all the help in the world and trust that he's going to help you. No matter where he goes, if he goes that way, right, and tries to come back in, your partner's there to help.
Start working out. There you go. Good job. There you go.
Oh. Great job.
The sign of a true leader is that they never stop learning and always encourage feedback. Coach Kidd has armed himself with 2 assistant coaches that know what players want and need. Because they're still playing in Kristi Toliver's case, or because they're only a few months removed from hanging up their sneakers, in Jared Dudley's case.
Huge transition. You're here all day, watching film. Meetings before and after, getting ready for how we're gonna do our stations, our groups, teaching points. After, we watch and film up practice, what we need to incorporate for the following day. What players we wanna see together during the scrimmages. So, I mean, listen, we always knew coaches were valuable. You see how much video coordinators work their butt off, and you see assistant coaches of what they're trying to get done. And so, it's been cool, man. It's different. At nighttime, I'm at the laptop breaking down film and what I wanna show my players to try to slowly get them better before this first preseason game.
Headbend.
Come on, let's go. We're gonna get the first win. New season, let's go. Mavs on 3, 1, 2, 3.
Mavs!
Thank you. Appreciate it. My best talk so far.
Welcome to the American Airlines Center, the beginning of the 2021-2022 season. The Mavericks and the Utah Jazz this evening. The teams and the opponent, not necessarily the important part of this, but a lot of excitement and obviously a lot of change. In fact, maybe as much change as we've seen around the Mavericks in the last quarter century.
Back door!
athlete, very diverse, extremely organized, and they just know the game of basketball. So for me, a basketball junkie, you know, I know I'm not going to be the smartest person in the room, but I'm going to learn a lot, so I'm really excited.
I haven't worked with Duds or Kristi, and so when you talk about with those two, one just finishing his career, and one still playing in Kristi, and so it's exciting to have that information because that's fresh information of just being able to ask them, as a player, what do you think? Would you like to do this at this time during practice, or would you like to do this? And so we get a lot of great feedback from them.
Players have their own language and their own anxieties, and that emotional understanding is the edge that Dudley and Toliver can bring to Coach Kidd's staff.
Yeah, I mean, it's an advantage of how you talk to players. I mean, players understand the grind, they understand the pressure, the stress, new coaching staff, new system. You're not going to win a starting battle in one day. And so for me, it's, you know, it's the right time when to watch film with them. If I have 30 clips, no player wants to watch 30 clips of themselves doing bad things. So it might be three or four things, a couple things that I show that they're doing right. And then when they're out there, keep emphasizing that's perfect. That's the way you're supposed to do it. Or, hey, listen, you see why they made the three? That's what we were talking about in the film. So just, you know, precise, short and quick. And this team's already good. This team's a playoff team. You got one of the best players in the world. So for me, just if I can help them become 5 and 10% better, then I've done my job.
It's about putting in the work and enjoying the work. And, you know, these guys have been great. Their effort level has been 100%. They've improved every single day, and that's all you can ask for. So, you know, the attitude, the effort is at a 10, and that's fun. It's fun for players. It's fun for coaches. So that's our job, to just continue to build them, but also have fun with them and allow their joy to just be fulfilled.
And with expectations higher than they've ever been for this collection of Mavericks, Coach Kidd is hoping that he and his new staff can rise to the occasion sooner rather than later.
You talk about the journey, right? There's journeys within a journey, and the big journey is to win a championship and to build that culture and be able to sustain that for a long time. And so it takes time. And understand, we want to go far this season. Expectations are going to be high when you have the best player in the world. And so you're up for that challenge because he's going to make you better as a coach, and he's going to make you better as a teammate. And so we all want the same goal, and that's to win.